Good afternoon, everybody. We're about to get started in just 1 second.
We're popping.
Pull that on. No, I'm fat.
It's been a week ago.
20 pounds now, shit. 20 pounds now, son. It's still feisty, right? Smart ass. That's a good idea. You know I got a blue, but I don't know how to load it. I bet it ain't. I can't stand you. Did you choke? What's happening, Queen and DJ? This is Hamid Ali. This is my other host. He's not the DJ. You the DJ, Brandon. What up, though? I need to have you to be a guest on the show, Brandon. You need to inbox me whenever you free on a Saturday so I could get you in here. Did you do a mic check? Oh, my God. One of my ears sound like it's out.
Mic check. One, two.
Mic check. Why sound low?
No, it sounds funny, but I think it's this compression.
Mic check. One, two. What
I
is
hear
this?
You good.
Yo.
Mic check.
It was that commercial.
Can you hear me, though? You hear me good?
Yes. Yes.
I can't stand you. God damn. That shit hurt my ear. Oh. Hey, Calvin. I'm off tomorrow, Calvin, if you free. Call me.
What up, bro?
The show next week. Okay, Brandon. Don't forget. Okay, for sure. For sure. Shout out to everybody who's tuning in. We're going to start right after this. Ooh, thank you for this. Appreciate this. If y'all ain't got no energy and y'all need some energy, this right here, this is a ginseng pill. Boost your ass right up. Wish I was there. Gotta get this maternity shoot on, fam. Already, Calvin. You know, you welcome anytime. We had a great time.
You're always welcome to come back, dog.
For real. Always. Yo. And I need to tilt my mic. Woo. I'm a little special, y'all. Mic check. Oh, yeah. Something wrong with this ear. My check, yeah. I think this ear went out.
I just work with this one.
I ain't fucked up about it. Hey, Tweetie! I love you too, boo. You need to hit me up too so you can come bless the honeycomb hide. I need to meet my brother, Hamid Ali.
What up?
Yes. You know, he's an indie rapper. Yes.
Yeah.
Today's topic is naturism and nudism. But before we get started, as y'all know, it's Pisces season. I want to give a special birthday shout out to my grandfather. He turned 92 today.
Hell yeah.
Hell yes. Hand clap for Papa. Papa R.E. Roberts. Yes, my Papa turned 92 today. Happy born day to you, Papa, from your granddaughter, Mecca, and we love you, Papa. Yeah, so again, today's topic is naturism and nudism.
Yay.
Yes, for all my people who like to get naked.
Naked.
Yes, and for those who don't know what naturism or nudism is, it's a cultural and political movement practicing, advocating, and defending personal and social nudity, most but not all of which takes place on private property. The term may also refer to a lifestyle based on personal, family, or social nudism. So you have actual families
of nudists,
including the kids to the grandkids, everybody in the family, they're nudists.
So they're wearing like the little Tarzan belt?
They don't wear
not even that.
They wear nothing at all.
Damn.
Yes, nothing at all.
So like if they get like a rash or something, everybody see it.
Yes, if they get a rash or any kind of STI or any other sort of anything, you gotta fucking see it, yo. Yes. Naturism may take a number of forms. It may be practiced individually, within a family, socially, or in public. Additionally, there is also militant naturism, including campaigning, and extreme naturism is sometimes considered a separate category.
So they got like Xena Warrior princesses out here.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
It's real.
Well, you got a lot of people who love being naked. You know, some of them feel like you were born that way. Why not?
Well, I mean, we started off that way.
That's what they say.
You know?
Yes, history lesson. The Congress of the International Naturist Federation which is established in France, been going on since 1974, defined naturism as a way of life in harmony with nature characterized by the practice of communal nudity with the intention of encouraging self-respect, respect for others and for the environment. So it's like a whole movement.
It's a fucking hippies.
Yes.
It's Woodstock.
Yes, pretty much it is fucking Woodstock. And I don't see anything wrong with that. You know, you got to be comfortable in your own skin.
For real.
For real, because it's a lot of people who, whether they skinny, medium size, big, whatever, you have a lot of people who are not comfortable in their own skin, but you do have small, medium, and large who don't give a fuck.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, because shout out to the BBWs who be stripping at the strip clubs on Big Girl Night.
Shout out to Faison Love for getting butt naked in that movie.
You heard me. Couples Retreat. Hand clap for y'all.
For real, because he didn't give a fuck.
For real. I mean, he pretty much teaching people to embrace.
Embrace yourself.
Embrace yourself.
Embrace your body. Embrace everything. It's all natural.
It's all natural. Yes, several other terms that you could use for it. Social nudity, public nudity, skinny dipping, sunning, and clothes free.
The nakedness.
Naked, just butt naked.
Fucking naked.
Fucking naked. Yes. They have been proposed as alternative terms for naturism, but none has found the same widespread public acceptance as the older term, naturism, and in much of the United States, nudism.
Well, you know, when I hear naturism, it's just really like, you know.
It made me feel like they're getting one with the nature.
Well, yeah, I'm thinking of trees.
Yeah, trees and leaves and bushes and all that shit.
You know what I'm saying? That's how I just... I live amongst the trees.
I live amongst the trees. Yeah, the tree people.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Tree huggers.
Tree huggers. Yo, let's freaking tell y'all about that MILF life. Your ass is crazy. I'm a big dude. Get out there and get shot in the ass with a tranquilizer dart. Like a wild freaking. Like a wild freaking bear. Your ass is crazy, bro. They gonna treat you like Smokey the Bear, I mean. You too can prevent forest fires.
Hey,
hey, Ashley.
Hey, Ashley. What's up, mama?
Hey, queen. Thanks, everybody, for tuning in. Your ass crazy, y'all, man. Hey, I like teddy bears. My nigga a teddy bear, so I'm just saying, I mean, ain't nothing wrong. Y'all keep us warm, I mean. Hashtag big guy. Big guy gang. Okay, queen, just inbox me whatever day you free. Just let me know. My Mecca baby page should be out of jail in 6 more days. I know I've been locked up for a month.
You're on Mecca Bailey jail every other week.
I mean, I love it when you hate on me. I'm telling you, I love all my haters. I do. I'm being crazy. That milk money. That milk money. This song is for all my fine ass milks out there.
Hey, holla at your boy for real.
I swear it's a lot of fine milk. You know what milk is, mother? I like to fuck.
Yeah. Help you spend some of your milk money. In a good way. For charitable causes.
You got Facebook street cred. Already, queen.
Look, they done heard from her. They done heard about her in Facebook jails all across the nation.
And you know it. I love all my haters. I'm going to start saying that shit, Ashley. I got that Facebook street cred, Satan. Y'all crazy. They crazy.
nobody right on this block.
Walking around news might strike some dudes to rise or salute shit. I'm told that I have clothes on. You know me, Memphis. Girl, I know, sis. I mean, you gotta look at it. I just played that song for you, Keisha. You got that MILF money. That mother I like to fuck. You can't help it. You don't even look your age. You look like you in your early 20s. And they're pitching you naked without the clothes on because I'm pretty sure you fine. You work out. You work out junkie. I'm just saying. Shout out to all my fine MILFs. Huh? You know? Yes. I salute y'all. For real.
For real. Yes. Two salutes for me.
I feel like a man. That's right. You are now tuned back in to Fishbowl Radio Network's Mecca Beer Honeycomb Hot Out.
It's your boy, Hamid Ali.
Look who just see feels like this.
It's your boy, Hamid Ali.
Yes, and this is the Queen Mecca, yo. Yo, it is a gloomy Saturday in Texas. If you are in the greater state of Texas in the Dallas-Fort Worth area, it looks like it is about to rain. Yes.
I think we need it.
We actually do need it. Not only that, Texas statewide, it is roundup season. So if your ass got tickets and warrants and KPS warrants, blue warrants, all that shit, y'all better get that shit taken care of. Like, literally, they are not playing. You know, we have to pass the Cowboy Stadium to get to the radio station, and they got the shit up on a billboard, the electronic board.
Or keep your ass in the house.
Or keep your ass in the house until March 10th. Yeah.
They gonna come get you.
They gonna come get your ass. I had to shoot us for that. Yeah, so again, today's topic is naturism and nudism. You know, we encourage people, you walk around naked in your own house any fucking way.
Right.
So, I mean,
I like to air dry. I don't even like to dry myself off with a towel.
But you know what? They say that's the best way to dry off, air dry.
Yeah.
Because your pores and shit, they're still open.
Yeah, I'd rather just air dry and walk around.
Sit that elephant trunk on the... Let me rest it on the towel rack.
Rest it on the table.
Well, you know, for all my fat monkey chicks, I'm pretty sure they air dry, but they just let that towel sit in between their legs so all that water can drip out.
Yeah.
Or for my deep depth pussies.
All over your ball.
I gotta shoot myself. I had to. Fun fact, people interested in social nudity can attend clothes-free beaches and other types of ad hoc nudist events. At these venues, participants generally need not belong to a naturist club. An overlapping term to naturist with a similar definition, including birthday suitor.
All right, so I have a question about that. Do they have those beaches here? Because, like, I hear a lot of people, you know, they go overseas and they got them all over the place. But, like, here in the U.S., are those type of beaches around?
Yes, they are all over the U.S. Yes, they are. And we even have some in Texas.
What?
Yes, yes. We even have some in Texas. We sure do. Yes, you see all my little notes and shit. I mean, they're not only
little
just...
Notes.
Well, you know, I was got off work tired and I overdid myself. Yes, in Texas, we have them at Barton Springs Pool in Austin. It's top free, which is tolerated in Austin. We also have Hippie Hollow Park on the shore of Lake Travis, northwest of Austin. Yes.
Well, one is just topless.
One is just topless, and at Lake Travis, it's completely nude.
It's bucket naked.
Bucket naked. Yeah, so if you want to go and experience one of these nudist camps or nudist venues, you could take your ass right to Austin if you are in the greater state of Texas.
That's a 3-hour ride from here.
Yes. I mean, we got them in Florida. We got them in Vermont. I read up on
Vermont.
It. Vermont. They have
that's some cold water.
That's some cold ass water. You heard of people ice swimming?
Yeah. I've heard of that.
Yeah, they got nudist camps out there.
They do butt naked ice swimming.
Yes.
Boy,
motherfucking ball sex gonna be icicles and shit.
Right. Hell no.
I mean, I even read it was some in Colorado, too.
Oh, for real, Colorado?
Yes. Mary, you'd be surprised how many places in the United States, and Florida got a lot of them.
I know, Florida. I mean, Florida's is mostly beach. There's beach on all around the whole fucking state.
Yeah. Yes, Florida got a whole bunch of them motherfuckers. And, of course, overseas got them.
Yeah.
United States study by Alfred Kinsey found that 75% of the participants stated that there was never nudity in the home when they were growing up. 5% of the participants said that there were seldom nudity in the home. 3% said often. And 17% said that it was usual. The study found that there was no significant difference between that was reported by men and by women with respect to frequency of nudity in the home.
So what they're saying is, like, nudism is almost taught in the home type thing?
Yeah.
Well, I mean, it makes sense because, man, it was around my household, too. You had to hurry up and close your door unless you didn't want to see something you weren't supposed to.
Well, y'all are Puerto Rican. And y'all are around that beautiful ass water and the sun all the time.
Well, I want people to know this too, because I'm going to say this now. Like, living in Puerto Rico, it's normal to not wear socks all the time. You know what I'm saying? And wear sandals a lot everywhere. And you see a lot of people, you know, in tank tops. And people don't dress and you know, they don't cover themselves as much because it's hot as fuck.
Right.
You know what I mean? So, yeah, you do see a little more, but I just think... every family is different. Just some families are more open than others. You know what I mean?
Yeah, you're right. To call and engage in this conversation, you could dial up.
214-717-4678.
That number again?
214-717-4678.
Yes. And, I mean, I agree with you. That's just like in Texas. It'd be so damn hot in Texas.
Motherfucker don't want to wear shit.
Don't want to wear shit. That's why women always getting in trouble for wearing them booty shorts, and y'all get in trouble for wearing them basketball shorts.
I didn't know we got in trouble for that.
I mean...
I didn't.
Shout out to all my hit them with the hammers, because you got me fucked up. If my nigga finna walk out the house and he got on them basketball shorts, I'm sorry. I'm gonna have to buy you a size bigger, and especially if you ain't wearing no damn drawers, because you ain't finna be showing everybody your eggplant, all right?
You can buy some boxer briefs.
And you know what? I said that at work. I said that it make you want to buy him boxer briefs because he want to go commando.
Keep his junk in order.
You're not worried.
We're not talking about clothes. So
let's not. We're talking about not on clothes.
Right.
Many contemporary naturists and nudist organizations feel that the practice of social nudity should be asexual. For those who never heard of an asexual, it's the lack of sexual attraction to anyone or low or absent interest in it or desire for sexual activity. So they're pretty much saying most of the people who are in these groups, they have no sexual attraction towards...
Yeah, like they can look at naked bodies all day and they don't get attracted, like
they don't get aroused,
there you go.
You're welcome. We help each other. Teamwork makes the dream work.
Hey.
Yes. So, according to the organization who founded it, you know, the International Naturist Federation explains, each country has its own kind of naturism. And even each club has its own special character. For we too, human beings, have each our own character, which is reflected in our surroundings. Do you agree?
Yes. it was computing in my head, like, yes.
Yeah, I mean, I tell people to embrace your nakedness. There's nothing wrong with walking around being naked.
Now, do these groups just allow people to just come in, or like, do you have to set an appointment to come visit?
Well, it depends, because you have different acts of it. You got different acts of being naked. We'll let y'all know when I introduce this song.
Yeah, we'll let y'all know in a minute, but first we're going to hit y'all with that Jeremiah London.
I mean, let me know when it's legal. I'll be like Pops from... Wait a minute, let me scroll back down. He said, let me know when it's legal. I'll be like Pops from Friday. Jumps is swinging this way, balls the other way. Yep, you can see. You crazy.
future, you know, nudity is a beautiful thing, but nowadays it's scary because the devil comes through people like fathers, siblings.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. You're right.
That's
you're right. Because you got a lot of sicko motherfuckers out here who look at their daughters. Prime example, your president. That's a prime example. Look how he look at his daughter. Look how he just walk around. Grab his pussy. You grab that pussy to her. You right, Keisha. I agree.
White boy. produced by a cat named Lewis. LOLOL, wow, I'm proud of you, girl. Nah, Jay, you on point.
Appreciate it, thank you.
Don't you feel it? His head gonna say, I'm joking. I love my brother. He's hilarious. Facebook Live or tune in radio app in the Red Room or FBRN.us
on the Red Stream.
On the Red Stream.
Or that tune in app.
Or that tune in app.
On the Red Stream.
In the Red Room.
In the Red Room. From 3 to 5.
Central Time.
On Saturdays. Los Sábados Gigantes.
Just like that. We silly, y'all. It's a gloomy day in Texas. We needed this rain. And we still got a beautiful view. I love looking at that Texas Ranger Stadium and the Six Flags over Texas.
I love how you did not say the Cowboys Stadium.
You see how I left that out?
I love that.
Already.
I love that.
Because neither one of us are fans.
Yeah, I don't see that.
Yeah, if y'all watching the Facebook Live, y'all can see him with his Buffalo Bills hoodie on.
Man.
I'm not a fan of him either, but look, I ain't fucked up about it.
Hey, I go for whoever going against the Cowboys every Sunday.
Yes.
That's my team.
Yeah, shout out to my boy Tony Brown at Brown's Barbecue. If y'all are in Fort Worth, Texas.
In the funk.
For real, y'all need to get at him. Yo, he got this brisket nacho. I gotta go have that joint. Like, for real, I gotta have that joint.
Ooh.
Ooh, we both. Shout out to him because he just said he needs to come bring us some plates. Yes, you do, Tony. You need to come bring us some plates.
Man.
We love barbecue.
I love to eat.
We could, I see. Yeah, I'm fat too. Anywho, today's topic is naturism and nudism.
Right, because I don't care. I'm fat and I still get naked. Yeah, bitch.
You heard me, yeah, bitch. I still get naked on your ass too. You shouldn't come to my house.
Look.
Who told you to come visit me?
Right. Traumatizing people all around the world. Nobody give a fuck.
Close your eyes. I'm just saying. The usage and definition of these terms varies geographically and historically, though in the United States, naturism and nudism have the same meaning. In Britain, there is a clear distinction between the two. Like we said, when we think about naturism, we think about
Trees and shit, and foliage, and fucking the state park, and Smokey the Bear, and all that.
Right, and that's how they look at it over there in Britain.
Well, yeah, you know,
but different slangs. In America, they look at it as the same meaning.
What you mean? Like,
they think that naturism and nudism have the same meaning.
Yeah, because we've already identified it to be one and the same in our dialect.
Right. Yeah. So in the acts of being naked.
So what word do they use if they don't use naturism or not like that?
Who, the UK?
Yeah.
They use those words, but they have two different definitions for
it. So them. Like naturism to them automatically is just trees and
like this, forest.
This bloke loves naturism. He loves to be in the trees. And
yes.
Skip through the park. And
yes. With his dougalay hanging. Yes.
With his girth hanging.
Yes.
Oh, okay.
Yes, nudism.
Nudism is nakedness still.
Yes. It is the act of being naked, while naturism is a lifestyle which at various times embrace nature, environment, respect for others, self-respect, crafts, healthy eating, vegetarianism, teetotalism. I have no idea what that is.
Meaning.
Non-smoking, yoga, physical exercise, and
pacifism.
As well as nudity.
You're not jumping into any confrontations or anything.
Right. That's why they say a lot of asexuals, they take heed to this because they are not getting sexually aroused. This is how they want to be. They're comfortable with their poom-pooms and boobies and ding-a-lings and man boobs just dangling everywhere.
Yeah.
Yeah, and I think that is
Yeah, they go do yoga and they don't have to leave and walk off because they...
But that's crazy because, look, damn near everything that we talk about coincides with yoga.
Yeah, I want to do yoga. I ain't gonna lie to you.
Oh, Lord.
I want to do some yoga.
I can just imagine.
Russell Simmons do yoga? Shit, I want to do some yoga, too.
Like, for real, it stimulates your mind, man.
For real, I'm super down.
And it keeps you younger.
Man, I'm really down.
Let's talk about naturist parlance.
Yes. What is that?
Textile or textilist is a non-naturist person. Non-naturist behavior or non-naturist facilities. The textile beach starts at the flag. They are a mixed couple. He is naturist. She is textile. So it's like one is either or. You good. One is either or. Fun fact. Textile is the predominant term used in the United Kingdom. You know, over there.
Yeah. So this is their little.
This is their shit. Textilist is unknown in British naturist magazines, include H&E Naturist. They got their own magazine.
Oh,
damn. Yes, H&E Naturist. Although some naturists avoid it due to perceived negative or derogatory connotation, which is understandable.
Yeah.
Because a lot of people like to criticize other people. And I think that is sad. Everybody is entitled to their opinion, but you have a lot of people who critique people because of the lifestyles that they live.
I mean, you know, we live in the day and age that social media will pick up everything.
Everything.
And the first thing people do is just start
judging
and picking and judging. And it really is just because of the lack of self-love for themselves that right. They have to beat down and tear down someone else and talk about what they don't have or what they don't do. You know what I mean? Or how they don't look. It is what it is.
Because you even heard it say that they are big advocates of self-respect.
Yeah.
They are big on that. Even their confederation said it. You know, the founders of this, you know, since the damn 70s.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure none of them people have fucking Facebook accounts or anything. Like, they, you know, they don't get down at all.
At all, you know. Also, we have at-home nudists. Many people are often nude in the privacy of their home or garden.
Garden.
In the backyard. Yes.
That's how you get peeping toms.
Either alone or with members of the family. They are called at-home nudists. Personal and family nudity. So this is like the whole family participates in it.
Yeah. I don't know about that one.
Right. It says, I'm not even kidding.
But all the kids come out.
Yeah.
You know what's fucked up about that is that someone's going to interpret that fucking wrong, and they're going to call
them
like, these people out here with their kids bucking naked, picking tomatoes in the backyard.
And see, that remind me, that's why I love that cartoon Family Guy. Family Guy had a family.
Like that.
A nudist family like that. Where you see Peter putting the little coasters down on the floor when they're entering the house and shit. Shout out to the creators of Family Guy, man. Y'all touch on every damn thing.
Real.
Y'all do. At-home nudists, this may be occasional nudity or as a naturist lifestyle. There are differences of opinions as whether, and if so, to what extent parents should appear naked in front of their children, and whether children should be nude within the home in the view of their family as well as visitors. This has attracted a great deal of academic study. So it's a lot of people who
that are trying this in their homes.
Yes, and they are fucking studying the shit. Yes.
Wow.
Yes, it's crazy. Like, I don't know if I would be comfortable walking around with my tits and poo-poo hanging out in front of the kids.
It's a little different, you know what I'm saying? But like I said, in my home, it was like, it would be just like she'd be walking from the bathroom to the, you know what I'm saying, to the room. It was like, if you didn't want to see that shit, hurry the fuck up and get out the way.
Well, that's different, but as far as I'm cooking in the kitchen.
No, that never happened, though.
We're sitting down at the fucking table, like it's real life families that do that shit.
Yeah, yeah. You know what I'm saying? Like that's pretty deep, right?
They're playing
there.
Monopoly and
oh no.
Uno and shit, booty butt naked.
Man, what if you get your public hairs in the food while you cooking this shit, man? That's fucked up. I'm just saying, man, like over the stove and shit, milk boiling, your bags hanging, and the fucking water splatter up, third degree burns on your boobs. But I'm just saying, it's just dangerous. You gotta be careful out here.
You gotta be careful out here.
It's a hard knock life for nudists. It's a hard knock life for nudists.
I hate you. You make my ass hurt.
Y'all already know what time it is.
And we about to go. Want to say something in Spanish to him?
But y'all can tune in on the app and listen to us. Y gracias, mi gente, por escuchar todos los sábados cuando nos ven.
What he said. Besos, everybody.
Deuces.